the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555. Jacksonville.
This is a Trent Baalke Masterclass.
The Jaguars Pro Bowl linebacker has reached agreement on a five-year, $150 million contract that includes $88 million guaranteed.
An all-out blitz. They hit him as he lets it go. The ball comes out. The ball comes out and it's picked up. The Jags are running it back. The Jags are running it back. The Jags are going to run it into the end zone. Josh Allen scores a touchdown. Josh Allen is running back for a touchdown for Jacksonville.
They throw a, it could be a double pass. This is Boyd. Now he wants to throw it back. And the ball picked off by the Jaguars. Josh Allen, has he done enough this year yet? He picked off the double pass and ran it back inside the 10-yard line of the Cincinnati Bengals.
1010XL 92.5 FM presents Jaguars Today with your hosts Mike Dempsey, Tony Smith, and Dylan Denmark.
Oh, Pockets trying to stir the pot this morning. Ask him to do that, Tony, with the Baalke Masterclass.
No, he let me know as I was coming to the studio. He's like, I got something for the open today. I was like, all right.
Well.
Yeah.
The Masterclass is in session. Oh, but wait, Tony, he didn't do it on someone's particular timetable. So they're not happy about it. Honestly, other than the timing of when Josh Allen got signed, I don't know how you're upset about this one right here. And you look at the particulars. By the way, welcome in everybody. Jaguars Today. Josh Allen has reportedly re-upped with the Jags. $88 million guaranteed, $150 million over 5 years. We'll find out whether those are the actual figures in the next few days.
There's the potential
whatever.
For Josh Allen to play here under contract for a decade.
Yes.
Right.
From the moment he was drafted for a decade. He's under contract for the first decade of his career.
What exactly that last two, three, four years looks like, we have no idea.
Might be 3 years and renegotiate the deal again. Might be a lot of things. But we know this. He's not here. He's not going to be on the franchise. Or he is here. He's not going to be on the franchise tag next year or this year for that matter.
Yep.
And I'm going to presume that somehow Josh Allen got over the tremendous disappointment of Trent Baalke not talking to him for 2 weeks.
It would appear so.
And imagine that. Imagine somebody being willing to take $30 million after somebody disrespected him like that for two whole weeks, Tone, of not talking to them. It's stunning that Josh Allen would take $150 million from anybody. I mean, that to me was where some of this got silly, that Josh Allen's not going to resign with Trent Baalke. Josh Allen hates Trent. Everyone hates Trent Baalke. They're certainly taking his money.
Yeah.
Or Shad Khan's money through Trent Baalke's offers.
At least be reasonable enough about it on the day that they get the deal done to backtrack on that opinion. Right.
Look, I get, if you got this done and you, and we don't know what the cap figure is going to be for the first year. If you had more, maybe you could have got the Ridley deal done. But then that's presuming you could have franchised Ridley, obviously.
There are legitimate things to react to the deal getting done. They could have done X, Y, and Z if X, Y, and Z had happened, right? Like, there are legitimate things to react to with this deal. I think the idea for anyone out there who was holding against Baalke, Josh Allen will never take his money because he just doesn't like it. It's like, well, stop. Right, like, that's nonsense. It's been shown to be nonsense today. That's nonsense. It's a nonsense take to have that opinion of Trent Baalke for that particular reason. Feel about Trent Baalke however you want to feel about Trent Baalke. Feel about them getting the deal done today as opposed to before the franchise tag deadline and the repercussions of that. What you want to put that with Calvin Ridley or whatever else they might have done in this offseason. I think some of that is fair. Some of it's unfair. You know, but some of it is fair to some degree. I do think the conversation we had going into the deadline with Josh Allen, as far as what you would need to be willing to pay to get the deal done before then, you see the guaranteed money is the biggest hint on this deal. He got $500,000 more guaranteed than Burns.
It was basically like, here's the Brian Burns contract. We're going to give you this little tiny bit so you can say you got more, but it's basically an identical deal.
One informed the other, and I felt like throughout the process, Trent Baalke is not bold enough as a GM to be the one to set the market for Burns, right? That was part of the reason I felt so sure that it was going to want to wind up on the franchise tag is, Baalke's not going to make the deal, right? And it's not that if this exact offer had been made before the deadline, I'm still not sure Josh Allen would have said yes to it before that trade deadline or the the franchise tag deadline.
Right. He might have wanted, like, that's the part that people
you just don't know.
I can't wait to find out. Because I presume they'll put something. Josh Allen out there and they'll have a press conference and let's talk about the timetable. How much did it bother you that things weren't getting done immediately after the season? And did this, you know, could the timing of this worked out differently for you? And maybe it could have, maybe it couldn't have. Don't, like you said, it takes sometimes the deal, like nobody seems to want to be the first of these big receivers to sign the next deal.
Yeah.
Because
someone's got to set it.
Whether it's Jamar Chase or Justin Jefferson or CeeDee Lamb, the next guy's going to want more, and the next guy's going to want more than that. So you want to be the third guy in the process.
Everyone got to react to Christian Kirk's deal, and it affected the money for so many wide receivers in the league. And the receivers are like, yeah, let's react off this. Absolutely. Right? Like, those things were all fair, and the Kirk deal, in hindsight, looks pretty good for the Jaguars and Balky having made that deal when they did for the amount of money that they did. Josh Allen was a similar kind of situation where it's different from the standpoint of, with Josh, you'd have to be willing to set the market to get him to say yes to a deal before today, right? Like, that's what it felt like to me. You got to be willing to set the market if you're going to get him to say yes to a deal before today, before the franchise deadline for sure. I think you would have had to been willing to set the market. They weren't.
And they didn't.
Right.
With this deal.
And they wind up giving him 30 a year,
which is a little more than Brian Burns, but it's not more than Nick Bosa, and it's not going to be more than TJ Watt gets in his next deal.
Yeah, I couldn't be happier, right?
I think
about
it's fantastic.
The Josh Allen deal. Like, I couldn't be happier because I was the guy when I heard it announced this morning. In my head, I don't care what the numbers are. Right, if they had announced he was getting 35 a year, I wouldn't have been upset because I'd have been willing to do it.
And
I would have been upset
that.
About the timing of it. It would have been like, well,
if you were
going to
pay him
ago?
That. But clearly, that's not Trent Baalke's job. Trent Baalke's job is not to give any player a blank check and just say, what would you like to make?
No.
He's getting near top of the market money. I don't think anybody thinks this is an unfair deal. Nick Bosa has been more productive than Josh Allen, by the way, right? And I think he deserves to make more based on the full body of work.
Yeah.
Josh Allen probably deserves to make more. You know, he certainly deserved to make more than Montez Sweat and Rashawn Gary, who got their deals last year, which were in the $24, $24.5 million range, something like that. So this is a reasonable bump up from that. And we'll find out. Like, and I get it. Like you say, Tone, if you thought, well, if they could have got this done, reduced his cap number, then they could have tagged Ridley. Maybe. Okay,
maybe.
But let's do the math. Okay, what was the receiver franchise tag? Like $22 million, something like
somewhere
that?
Somewhere in there, yeah.
And Josh was 24, right? Well, Josh is not free this year. No matter how much you reduce his cap number in the first year, it's not free, right? So it's going to cost something. Well, add that something to the $22 million in the franchise tag that you would have had to apply on Calvin Ridley, and do you have enough money to sign Arik Armstead?
Mm-hmm.
I don't know the answer to that question. Mm-hmm. Maybe they would have. We all heard there was a plan to keep Ridley, get Armstead, do the whole thing. So maybe there was a way they were going to structure the deal if they got the deal done with Ridley that they had on the table with him. But maybe they wouldn't have been able to structure it, Tone, to take on $22 million immediately and only have that and not have anything beyond that for the long term. And it doesn't change that dramatically unless you think you're going to get a long-term deal done with him as well. The need going into the draft, you know, it's not like they could have signed Josh Allen and then signed Ridley prior to the opening of free agency because they still would have been giving up that second round pick. And they were clearly not willing to do that in the deal. But I mean, other than that, I really don't see what the issue is. I think Josh Allen's going to be fine. He's going to be motivated. Now, I would hope this means he's going to show up for everything throughout the offseason.
Yeah.
We're giving you $30 million. Need to see you in attendance here.
Mm-hmm.
Now, what we also need to see is how about another 15-plus sacks, all right? I don't want you to go back to being a 7-sack guy. I want you to be this guy. We're paying you now to be an elite pass rusher, not just a good one. Not the best of what we have, but one of the best of what the league has to offer. Here's my question to you, Tone. Now that this is long-term, right, locked in for 5 years, Trayvon Walker's young. He's not even eligible for a contract extension. He's got several more years left, plus the fifth-year option on his deal. Does this change your interest level in taking like a Jared Verse or any other pass rusher early in the NFL draft?
Not really.
Okay.
I'm not any less interested.
It does to me to some degree.
Right? Like, if Jared Verse happened to be available when the Jags are on the clock at 17, I think there's probably a good argument to be made. Like, most lists you see of the rankings of players, and I don't know what the Jaguars list looks like, obviously, mm-hmm. but most lists of rankings of players, you'll see Verse somewhere around 11 or 12, mm-hmm. right? And so if the Jags were on the clock at 17 and Verse was available, I'm as interested today in being willing to make that pick as I would have been yesterday.
What is his path to a starting job here in Jacksonville? There is none. Is there? Unless Trayvon becomes a full-time defensive tackle.
Yeah.
He's a rotate. For me, I can't do that. I can't, like, if Josh Allen's playing on the franchise tag and there's any degree of uncertainty about his long-term future here, okay, I can get that because he's going to contribute anyway. You do rotate a bunch of guys in. But if next year we're looking at Josh Allen and Trayvon Walker and the year after that we're looking at Josh Allen and Trayvon Walker, I don't see giving the 17th pick to an edge rusher. That's me.
Like, I think it was unlikely before the Josh Allen deal got done. I don't think that was going to be a big part of whatever the plan was going to be for the Jags.
I'm not even talking about likely or unlikely. I'm just talking more about your interest level.
For me, it's about the same.
Yeah, mine is definitely less. And it was lower compared to some of those other positions anyway. But, I'm not going to freak out. If Jared Verse, they have graded as better than the 17th best player in this draft, and they think he's the best guy on the board. I get it. It makes sense. Mm-hmm. Pass rush is a position that when teams double and triple down on it, we praise them, right? But, again, 17th pick. For a team that has as many holes to fill as I think they still do in terms of high-end capability at wide receiver and corner, maybe defensive tackle, certainly offensive line depth, I've got other priorities right now. But mm-hmm. we'd love to hear from you today, your reaction. Thank you to the Jaguars and Josh Allen for making, as Tony said, my exit show for the week an easy one. What are we going to talk about today? Well,
I think it's been written.
I think it has been written. So your best opportunity to get in and weigh in with any reaction to this that you'd like is right now at 641-1010 on the All-Pro Roofing phone lines, because as scheduled today, unless something pops up because of the news of the day that inhibits somebody from joining us. We've got Demetrius Harvey at 10:40. We've got John Osier next time. We'll certainly take some calls when we've got Osier on as well if you want to get in then. But if you want to get in right now, it is wide open to you for your reaction, good or bad. All right, I'll let you have your say. I just think this is a great day for the Jags, and I think the only thing is, should have done it earlier. Like, I even had somebody say, man, it's a great deal considering I thought the guaranteed money ended up being a lot more, but the timing still. Well, maybe that's don't you have to negotiate that money? Like, maybe Josh Allen said, hey, Brian Burns got this, I want this. No, Jags are like, nope. And they finally met in the middle.
They figured a deal out.
As negotiations typically end up doing.
And that's not an argument, I don't think, to say the timing couldn't have been better.
It might have been able to be better, but it might not have been able to be that much different.
But it is an argument for the process of actually getting that deal done with Josh Allen that it came to today is not necessarily a terrible process, right? Like, maybe you could have got a deal done, you know, before the franchise tag deadline. Maybe, but I don't think 30 a year would have done it. I don't think so.
Now, I don't know.
We'll hear from Josh Allen.
Well, that's the thing. What were they offering before the franchise tag deadline? Was it anything?
Right.
Was there a firm offer on the table, or did he want to wait? I will say this. If he would have taken this all along, and if it was out there and the deal was to be made, then Balky should have made it sooner.
Agreed.
Right? I mean, absolutely should have made it sooner, if for no other reason than to see what that would afford you in terms of cap space. Now, if they have more cap space, does that mean Calvin Ridley is here if you go that route? Well, yes, if you franchise tag him, right? Mm-hmm. Do we know if they wanted to franchise tag him? You know what I mean? Like I know there was no way that Josh Allen was going to get out of Jacksonville. That became clear. Would they have felt that way about Calvin Ridley had Josh Allen not been in this position? He had the long-term deal. Possibly.
Yeah, maybe.
Probably.
The franchise tag was a whole lot easier to work out the timing of it when it came to the draft.
And then try to work out a deal.
Sign it tomorrow. I don't care
if they franchise tag Ridley and nobody can talk to him, he's probably right. has signed a long-term a deal with options, the Jags today.
You know, at that point in time. Like, the only leverage he'd have, as we talked about, was if you put the tag on me, I'm signing it the moment you put it on me.
Correct.
Like that's the only leverage he could have had.
That's true, and he could have done that.
He could have at least put that pressure on the Jags. They weren't in that situation.
Right. So we don't know. But your reaction to it, however, whatever you see in it, give us a call, 641-1010, and we'll let you have your say on that. You can also hit us up on the text line designed by Lifetime Enclosures at that same number. The YouTube chat is buzzing away. Or hit us up on social media at MD_1010XL, at 1010XL Fat Tony, and at 1010XL Denmark.
Hold my pocket.
That's our guy Pockets right there. He's busy right now with the phone calls. We'll say hi to him later. Demetrius Harvey later this hour. John Osier next hour. Tons of Jag talk, mostly the Josh Allen deal. 5 years, $150 million, $30 million average, and about $88 million guaranteed is the initial reporting on that. We'll see where the numbers ultimately settle. Maybe right there, maybe a little less, that as is often the case. But we'll find out. We'll take your calls straight ahead with Tony Smith and Dylan Denmark. I'm Mike Dempsey. You're listening to Jaguars Today on 1010XL 92.5 FM.
It's a Weight Loss Wednesday on 1010XL. A week in 180 weight loss.
From the Jacksonville Orthopedic Institute studios.
When the sun goes down, Hacker is up.
Who is that guy?
Ryan the Hacker Green.
You're one of our very special people here.
He'll tell you about tonight's games and hot topics. Hacker After Dark, right after Rick Ballew. Evenings on 1010XL.
Bold City Heating and Air is truly a family-owned and operated local company and treats all customers like family. Don't be fooled by the out-of-towners, equity firms, and national corporations that use local names. There's one name you can trust when it comes to your home's AC cooling system. Bold City Heating and Air. Jacksonville grown and entirely loyal to this community. Don't wait until it's too late. Schedule your summer maintenance now by visiting boldcityac.com.
Ever wonder how you can transform your living spaces into captivating works of art? At First Coast Lighting and Fans, they offer a huge selection of high-quality products to match your desire for elegance, quality, and uniqueness. Visit their showroom on Phillips Highway at the Avenues and step into a world of quality without compromise. Discover the difference that locally owned expertise makes and let them help you experience the transformation from average to extraordinary. At First Coast Lighting and Fans.
Those sound like some well-oiled machines. Hey, Glenn here from B&B Oil. If you have equipment that needs fuel and only want the best for your engines, we've got you covered. From fuel for boats to construction sites with large equipment, we deliver all types of fuel and lubricants. We also have tanks from 250 gallons to 2,000 gallons and larger if you need them. Give me a call and let's talk. Find us online, bb-oil.com.
Attention real estate agents, loan officers, and mortgage professionals. Trust your real estate closings to the expertise of St. John's Title, LLC. As a board-certified attorney-owned and operated firm with years of experience, St. John's Title provides the utmost of precision and professionalism. With conveniently located offices and in-home remote closing options, our customer-first approach ensures a seamless process tailored to your timeline. Join our team of experts and five-star testimonials from customers across the First Coast. Choose St. John's Title.
He was the best back in Jacksonville.
It has to be Fred Taylor.
Fred Taylor joins Dan and Jeff on The Drill Monday mornings at 8:30.
A tough guy.
Monday morning running back with Fred Taylor is fueled by Epstein and Robbins and B&B Fuel and Lubricants. You're
shrimping. Jumbo Shrimp Baseball, presented by FIS, is home all week at 1-to-1 Financial Ballpark. Tomorrow is Coors Light Thirsty Thursday with beer specials, then it's Red Shirt Friday with fireworks, and the first 2,000 fans on Saturday get free Jumbo Shrimp pajama pants, plus more fireworks. Baseball all weekend with tickets starting at just $5. Log on to jackshrimp.com for tickets. Jumbo Shrimp Baseball, affordable family fun.
We love talking sports on 1010XL, and I-9 Sports love giving kids the perfect way to grow up playing sports. Summer and fall registration is underway, and if you log on to i9sports.com, you'll see all they've got to offer for kids 3 and up. And don't forget to enter 1010 in the promo code for a discount on registration. Year-round sports all across the First Coast, from St. John's, Duval to Clay. Summer and fall registration open right now. Fort Family Field and Westside Middle, or online at i9sports.com. Get your kids in the game with I-9.
Mortgage rates have lowered going into this spring selling season.
Have you had problems selling your home in the past? Are you looking for a promise, a solution? I'm here to give it for you. It's Chad and Sandy and ChadandSandy.com, the real estate experts I trust and recommend with the sale of your home, or mine for that matter. Maybe you want maximum equity, or perhaps you're worried about costly repairs or upgrades. Chad and Sandy deliver this simple promise. They guarantee your home sold at an agreed-upon price and deadline, or they will buy it. You have literally nothing to lose. Take Pete in Lakeshore. I was in a pickle. I heard Chad and Sandy on the radio and called because I needed to cash out on a rental property fast. I was struggling to rent it. I called Chad and Sandy, and I got an offer for full asking price within days. These guys made it easy and delivered big time results. Call the agents I trust and recommend to sell your home. Chad and Sandy, they guarantee to sell your home or they will buy it. Find out more at ChadandSandy.com or call 414-6200.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555. Jacksonville. Jaguars today on 1010XL.
All right, Jaguars today, big day. Josh Allen re-signs with the team. Top 10 draft pick re-ups for the next 5 years. Has always expressed he wanted to stay in Jacksonville and really put it all together last year for one of the best seasons in Jaguar history.
Yeah.
On any side of the ball, 17 and a half sacks, and hopefully he'll be a regular visitor in the double-digit district in terms of sacks, at least for the next 3, 4, 5 years.
Yeah.
And let's hope that's the case. And, you know, for everyone who talked about what a bad signal this sends, no one's going to want to sign here because they don't reward their own players, or what now? First of all, they signed a bunch of guys before this happened. That's I think, for the most part, a crazy argument because people take the money and they do what benefits them. Oh, they stuck it to Josh Allen. They're offering me how much? Yes, please. That's what happens, right? Tony gets a bad deal from 1010XL and they offer me $1 billion or vice versa. You know what I mean? Right? Yeah. Like, hey, all right, man, I wish I hadn't done that to Tony or Mike, but this is a hell of an opportunity for my family and Josh Allen. You know, money talks, and the organization gave it to him. He took it, so let's move on, all right? Yeah. But today's the day to react to it for sure.
You know, we were just talking in the break. There's been so many situations that didn't work out happily in the end, right, in Jacksonville. And we can go through the whole list of them with Jalen and Jan and all those guys, right? Like, it just didn't work out in the end for them to be here long term. Josh is here long term.
Yeah.
And he's a really good football player. And he's a first round pick. And he loves it.
Always
here.
Wanted to be here.
Right.
Right.
Like, all those things are all lined up and the deal got done. Let's celebrate, guys.
Yeah. Well, you know? Look, I'm not going to tell you how you have to react to it,
no.
Right? Like, I'm extremely happy, but I'm more like, okay, it's done. I did think it would get done by July. I didn't think it was coming this quick. I was surprised when Mike DeRocco said, this could get done by the draft.
Mm-hmm.
He was right.
He was.
That I didn't expect to have happen, but since then they got the Foyer-Lewican deal done and now the Josh Allen deal done, so apparently they are doing more than one thing at a time.
They're doing work.
They're doing a ton of it,
yeah.
Whether you agree with every move they've made. Now, did they do everything perfectly? Like, Jason Light has won a Super Bowl with the Bucs. Pretty good GM, right?
Mm-hmm.
Why don't they have a deal done with Antoine Winfield? But he's under – do yeah. they – are they – not taking care of their own draft picks? What kind of signal is this sending to Mike? Oh, what, Mike Evans took the money? Oh, he did?
He did.
Oh, he did take the money. Because
mm-hmm.
that's what happens sometimes. You can't get a deal done before the franchise tag deadline. I know people are going to say, well, they could have if they negotiated during the season. That's his philosophy. He doesn't do it. Some teams don't.
Yeah.
Right?
I don't like the philosophy. I agree.
But that's what
he
does.
That's the philosophy.
And
yeah.
I get, like, I don't see any reason why he couldn't pick up the phone 2 days after the season ended and say, hey, you're a priority, right?
Totally
and,
agree.
And that, but it doesn't seem to have impeded. Like, if you had told me today the price tag was $40 million or 30, you know, I would have said Josh Allen squeezed him. You know, $30 million seemed like the number, right? 28 to 30 million.
Yeah, in light of all the other information.
In light of
yeah.
all the other contracts that got done. Somewhere in that range where it wasn't Bosa, but it was a little bit better than Burns, and it was better than the other guys who got their deals done last year because he's a better player, and that's mm-hmm. exactly where it ultimately
it
ended up.
Yeah.
If it's that easy, if you could say, then why don't we just offer this? Because it's a negotiation. We don't know what either side was looking for. at that point in time. Right. And if again, you open with this and Josh opens with some other number, you're ultimately paying more than this.
We'll hear from Josh at some point. And
can't wait.
He'll be asked, I'm sure, about the process and whatever happened, you know, to wind up with this mega deal. He's the first $100 million man in Jaguars franchise history. Right? Like, he's the first one to sign.
Ain't going to be the last.
Right? A contract. Yeah, there's a few more coming. Here in the very near future, we would hope.
I would suspect one of them is going to get done this summer.
Right. But, you know, Josh is a guy who, with everything that he's accomplished in his career, with everything we've talked about through all this, throughout this process with the tag and all the different ways, the machinations for how this whole thing could work out, seeing the deal getting done today doesn't mean that that's the deal that could have gotten done. Right.
At that time.
Right. Before the franchise tag deadline. I'm not saying that it's impossible that this would have been enough. I don't know.
Don't know.
What the answer to that is. Like, he may have been willing to sign this contract then. I don't know what
the
answer
is. And you may have been able to sign it for 25 last year.
Maybe.
And again, maybe. And if you were, well, you were paying a guy $25 million who hadn't had that 17.5 sack season. You would have been paying a guy who had 7 or 7.5 the last couple of years and an injury plague season the year before that. Anyway.
The timing of all of it's hard to know. And we'll hear from
hopefully
Josh.
Hopefully we'll learn more details on it. Let's get out to your reaction at 641-1010. Hunter going to lead things off on Jaguars today this morning. Good morning, Hunter.
Good morning, guys. How are you?
Good. What's up?
Can I talk about the upcoming draft, what I think the Jaguars should do?
No, not really. Today's the kind of reaction to Josh Allen Day. Do you have a reaction to it? Okay. That's what we're doing today. If you want to react to Josh Allen's deal, we've been talking about the draft like nonstop every day for weeks and weeks and weeks.
We'll
continue to get back to the draft, but we're not focusing
on that.
We'll
probably get into it a little bit with Demetrius in the next segment.
We might,
too. Yeah.
But we're taking calls right now on your reaction to Josh Allen getting his deal done. David, do you have a reaction to Josh Allen getting his deal done with the Jags?
Yes, I do. Just a heads up, I don't call it as much. I've been so busy with working and funny, but I listen every day. I love you guys. But I was really excited the fact that the deal got done. I was never worried that it wouldn't get done, but I kind of felt like Tony. I kind of felt a little bit antsy, being that we lost some key guys in the past that we weren't able to get done. So I woke up today. I was really, really, really excited. And I kind of think it worked out in a good way, because if we would have got it done before, we probably would have signed Calvin Ridley, and we might have not got Eric Armstead. So I feel like even though we lost Calvin Ridley, I feel like it was a net gain, because even though we lost Calvin, we still got Gabe Davis, and we still got Eric Armstead, which I feel like we really, really need in our defensive line. So I really love the direction we're going in. I love the show. Thanks for taking my call.
All right. David, appreciate it, man. Look, I don't know for a fact that they couldn't have made it all happen, right? Because when they were talking about doing a deal with Ridley, they even said, we wanted Ridley and Armstead.
Got the money for that and Armstead.
Right. But that was Ridley agreeing to a deal that who knows what the first year number would have been. If you tag Ridley,
you know what the number is.
You know what the number is. It's $22
million,
which is probably significantly more. Look at all these deals that they've signed. Like, Eric Armstead's cap hit is what, like $4.5 million this year? Something crazy low, right?
Yeah.
And so I'm imagining they had something set up where Ridley was going to have a really much lower cap hit than $22 million, obviously, and it would have made all these things work. Now, Josh Allen's cap hit would have been lower, but would the combined number have been manageable for the Jags? I don't know. I'm not saying it wouldn't or it would. I can't. That's the thing.
They would have known.
We presume they know.
Yeah.
We don't know what they know.
Yeah.
Right? And we sit there and we go, well, this is not going to happen, or this is going to happen, or Balky thinks this, or Josh Allen thinks this. We don't know any of those things, what they're thinking, unless they tell us what they're thinking. And so for all we know, they've been working diligently on this for a while. Josh Allen's attitude may have been, let's just get this done. You know, like, hey, I'm not worried about it. It's going to get done. I see good movement. And the timing's really not that big a deal. To him, in the end, sign this deal now or a month ago. Okay, I guess there's some interest, right? if you throw it in the but other than that, Tone,
right,
your life is set financially. And you were in pretty good shape anyway in the last month. I think you probably didn't miss a meal, is my guess.
Probably not.
You know, so, but, I get it. That's not the only ball that we're juggling here, the timing of it. I totally understand that. Mm-hmm. PJ on the west side wants to weigh in. PJ, what's your reaction to the Jags and Josh Allen getting a five-year deal done?
First of all, good morning, gentlemen.
Good morning, sir.
I just want to say, man, I'm so happy that they finally got this deal done. I mean, it might have took a little bit longer than what we wanted, but you know what? All in all, the deal is done. I'm happy. Man, I'm about to go to the house when I get out of work. I'm going to throw some ribs on the grill. Man, I'm about to have myself a little party, man.
Hey, hang on the line. Give Dylan your number. I'll swing by for some of those ribs. I got the afternoon free. PJ, thanks for the call.
Yes, sir.
Man. Enjoy those ribs.
You guys have a blessed day.
Thank you, buddy. Appreciate that. Look, again, there are a lot of people out there, I get it, that don't like Balky or critical. And I think there are plenty of fair reasons to be critical of him. Mm-hmm. I do believe that of that, whatever percent that is, that 97.8% of them really just want the team to succeed, right? I think that the people, there's a small, tiny segment that this bothers because it hurts their narrative today. But I think for most people, and I saw a lot of people reacting this way, hey, you know what? I've been critical of Balky. The timing's not perfect, but damn, how can you not be happy about this? We got our guy. We got our, you know, he's in. And I think that's generally the universal reaction that I've seen so far this morning. Let's get Jake out in Orange Park next up here on Jaguars Today. Good morning, Jake.
Hey, good morning.
Duval. Yes, sir.
I think it's officially time to name a street Josh Allen Lane. He's here to stay. I'm so happy.
That's not bad. I'm not in charge of that thing. I'm happy as well. And I'm not opposed to it, Tone. Now that we know he's going to be here for a while.
There may be some construction down in that area soon.
Right. Right.
Yeah.
You know, something like that.
We'll see.
What would we call that? Josh Allen Way? Josh Allen Lane?
Something.
Josh Allen, I don't know. Trevor Lawrence Pass would be a good one.
Uh-huh.
Right? You could
pretty good.
Get that. Josh Allen, in parentheses, Rush Lane, maybe? No, I don't know. Let's go to James and Nocatee. They're coming in now. Let's get your reaction to Josh Allen getting a five-year, $150 million deal. Again, the exact particulars of what the numbers work out to be will come out in the wash in the next 48 hours. James, you're on Jaguars Today. Go ahead, please.
It's a good day, boys.
It is a good
day.
Great day.
Yes, sir. I mean, seriously, anybody with a contrary opinion, they're not paying attention. I mean, I understand people are like, well, why didn't we do, you know, Ridley and then do Josh, or Josh then Ridley? And the organization clearly valued that second-round pick with higher than the contract they were going to give Ridley. There's more talent long-term under getting, you know, these younger players in under smaller contracts so that we can have money to move around in free agency or even give Trevor his money. So that's pretty much where it lies. I mean, that's pretty much – it has to be where it falls. Like, what's your opinion on that? Because – to me, that's exactly what happened. I'll take it off the air, boys.
All right. What do you think, Tone?
I didn't catch it all right there.
Just that I'm losing my train of thought because I'm listening to something Dylan's saying.
Yeah.
I'm doing the same. It's going right out.
Yeah. Sorry, man.
Yeah, no, I just totally blank because I apologize. I was trying to multitask. What he said, talking about the Ridley deal and the timing of it, and valuing the second-round pick, yes, that's what it was. It's obvious they valued that second-round pick pretty highly.
Yeah.
And it is, like, that 48 pick needs to be a guy. And I granted that Brenton Strange was not that guy last year. It wasn't the 48 pick. But regardless, second-round pick for this team right now needs to be a guy who contributes significantly to this football team. Like, right away, if not starting out of the gates, is – starting in short order.
Yeah, look, I think all of that was part of the process for why they weren't going to get the extension done with Calvin Ridley before.
It was never going to get the extension done.
I think all of that was part of it.
Could they have tagged him
and then,
had Ridley not signed the tag until after free agency opened up? Maybe.
Yeah, potentially.
But they clearly, to James's point, they were not willing to give up that second-round pick.
No, they weren't ever going to give up the second-round pick.
Right, and I think Balky made that clear as well in the process. And 48 to 96 is a huge drop, the quality of player that you're potentially going to get there. That doesn't mean you sometimes won't take the veteran over the pick, right? It just they wanted everything. And I'll tell you one thing that they were fortunate to do was go out and strike as quickly as they did on Gabe Davis. Because if they wait until Wednesday to see where it settles with Ridley, and I know they said they Gabe Davis told them, or they told Gabe, we want you and Ridley. That's the plan, right? But if they don't strike on Gabe Davis and get him done right away, somebody else comes along and takes him while you're trying to figure this out with Ridley by the Wednesday deadline at 4 o'clock, and you lose out on him. And now you're like, well, we have to draft a receiver at 17. Right, they may still, but they're in better position to not have to do that. Thank you, James, for the call. Sorry we both brain farted on you there for a second. Chuck in Jacksonville Beach up next. Chuck, what's your reaction?
Hey, good morning, guys. I think it's great news, and I think it just goes to show that, you know, when Balky said Calvin knows where we are, we know where he is, you know, if Tennessee hadn't come up with that ludicrously overpaid deal, good chance Ridley would have re-signed. But, you know, I just don't think that they, again, value spending that much money on Ridley. They've got the second-round pick. They got a young receiver, Davis, at a fraction of the cost. I think it's a great day all the way around.
All right, Chuck, appreciate it, man. And that's part of it, right? Like, they're allowed to have a value on a guy. They're allowed to say, Josh Allen, you're worth this and no more, right? And then there's a negotiation, and you settle where you want to settle. Did they want to pay Calvin Ridley $23 million a year on average? Were they willing to maybe suck it up on the franchise tag for a year and see how it played out with the idea that you're going to get a long-term deal and lower that cap number? That's probably the route they would have tried. I'm sure they would have, because they had a deal that was right there in place. You can't control when some other team comes in over the top. Maybe the idea is not put a timing mechanism in on draft compensation, whereas you say if Ridley hits X amount of yardage, you're going to get the second as opposed to the third. But to put it on signing an extension by this date puts you in limbo if you are not willing to give up that draft capital.
Today and them getting the deal done with Josh Allen doesn't make me forget or feel any differently about the roller coaster that I was feeling with the Calvin Ridley thing. Right, because when free agency was finally going to open and they had to use the tag on Josh, was that was the process they were at. I was convinced
he
signed somewhere else.
Then Gabe Davis signs, you really think he's gone.
Yeah, it's like it's over. And then the news comes out the day before all that's going to go down. It's like, all the talk is the Jags are probably leading the conversation with this. 15 minutes before the deal got announced, they were on NFL Network talking about the Jags are the team that's leading.
With like almost, about an hour and a half to go.
Right. Like this, the whole thing, it all felt like, okay, they're going to get it all done. Like whatever you feel about the process, everyone's coming back, right? Like that's the way that it felt. And I didn't feel that way 2 days before that. I did on the day of.
By the
way, like everyone's coming back. It didn't work out that way. I was really bummed out.
Tennessee said, Tony, some of their deals fell through and that they never expected to even pursue Ridley.
Yeah.
And that some of their deals fell through kind of in that 48-hour period.
Right.
And they're like, all right, let's take a shot and see what happens.
Shift
you know, and
it
happens that way. You can't know what all 31 other teams are planning on doing at any given time. Let's get one more in here. We got them stacked up, but we got Demetrius Harvey coming up. Maybe one or two here if we get them in quick. Coach B on the north side, you're next up. Go ahead, Coach.
Hey, how's it going, fellas?
Good.
Love
What's
your
up?
Show.
Thank you.
Oh, man, the timing of this thing, this could have been gotten this deal done. You know what I mean? But it's all in all, it's a good deal, and I love that we got him. But I'm a diehard Viking fan. I live here in Jacksonville. I put a Jaguars, but I'm a diehard Viking fan. What take these GMs so long to get the deal done? I'm going nuts every day waiting on something on Justin Jefferson, or we're going to give him his money. What is going on with these GMs and what takes the deal, makes the deals take so long?
Well, I think because it's a negotiation. Both sides want something different. One side wants to pay you as little as possible. The other side wants to get as much as possible.
Yep.
Right? I mean, that's what it comes down to. And Justin Jefferson, and part of it is, like we talked about earlier, is Justin Jefferson waiting until CeeDee Lamb and Ja'Marr Chase go? Who's going to blink first among those three big wide receivers? Because if you take the 30 or the 31 or whatever, a dollar more than Tyreek Hill, well, the next guy comes in and gets a million more than you, and the next guy gets it, and you feel, quote, disrespected, right? Please, someone disrespect me with $30 million. I really want to get disrespected like that, but I think that's what it comes to. I mean,
it's not like all the quarterbacks that have gotten deals done here in the last couple. It's not like Burrow got his deal done right when he could, right? It took time.
It takes
Herbert,
time.
It took time.
And it's not just like, okay, we're going to pay you $30 million a year. Good, right? And you write it up in a paragraph. There are a lot of stipulations to the stuff
right.
That's
and once
way
the deal gets done,
expertise.
Yeah, there's going to be a lot of, well, why? What? Why?
Yeah, why wasn't this done earlier? Who right. knows? Who knows? Again, at that time, what was Josh Allen seeking? What were the Jaguars willing to pay at that time? Maybe they did come up. And look, the fact that a deal got done before the draft leads me to believe that, yeah, I think Coach is right. This deal could have got done earlier, mm-hmm. probably. But that doesn't, even if it did, let's say it goes down that road. And Josh Allen gets a deal.
Yeah.
And Calvin Ridley gets franchised, and then he gets a deal. And we still sign Armstead. And everything's the same except we have Calvin Ridley.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? What if it turns out that you draft Brian Thomas and you're like, you know what? Sometimes you just fall right into it, Tone. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Like, if we had done it the way we had planned, we'd have Calvin Ridley, and we'd be happy.
I would be.
And
yeah.
we'd be spending that pick on corner or whatever, but what if that next receiver you do draft, who's going to be cheaper for 4 years than Calvin Ridley would be for a single season, mm-hmm. turns out to be just as good or better, right? And he's so much younger. And now you've got your guy growing with Trevor Lawrence. It could work out that way. Again, that wasn't the plan. They wanted Ridley back. They failed to get him back. But to say to fail to get him back, to me, doesn't mean that you failed the offseason.
No.
I think they've done a lot of good stuff this offseason.
Yeah. By the way, a lot of suggestions for the Josh Allen cul-de-sac.
done. Yeah. Retire that.
Right,
man.
Yeah.
That's good. Very nice. Whoever, all the smarter people than me that sent that in. All right. If you're on the line, we'll try to get back to you right at the top of the hour when John Osier joins us back. So you're willing to, or if you're willing to hold, we'll take you in the order that you're on there. If mm-hmm. you don't, you can always call back at 641-1010 on the All Pro Roofing phone lines. Appreciate everybody getting in today and understanding today. We've got one focus. That's this deal that Josh Allen got done. We'll get back to the draft in short order and everything else that comes with it, because heck, we're only 2 weeks out at this point in time. But we've got Demetrius Harvey from the Florida Times Union weighing in on this. On the other side, this is Jaguars Today on 1010XL and 92.5 FM. Hey folks, Mike Debs here for Dandy Food, sandwiches, subs, anything you need as you're driving around town. Let's say, I don't know, you forgot your golf shoes, right, at the house, and your buddy drove you all the way into Jacksonville, and then you had to take his car back to his house to get your golf shoes. That sounds like I know somebody like that, right? Well, maybe he needs to swing into a gate station, fill up my car, and then fill up his belly with some delicious Dandy and Anytime Deli offerings, man. I would suggest the tuna salad sandwich, but they've got something great for everybody. You might not like tuna salad. You might like a hot roast beef or a cold roast beef. They got a little something for everybody. Subs, sandwiches, breakfast items, anything you can imagine, kinds of breakfast sandwiches. They've got protein packs, fruit cups, veggie trays. You want something easy on the go that's not going to weigh you down, give you a little boost of energy. Dandy's got your back to swing into a gate station and be amazed at the variety that they offer. When you're hungry in Duval, do what I do, folks. Go out and make yours a Dandy. Do it today.
Helping you over the hump, Awaken 180 Weight Loss. Weight Loss Wednesday continues from the Jacksonville Orthopedic Institute Studios on 1010XL.
And now, the starting lineup.
The Drill. Mornings. Jaguars Today, 10 to noon. Helmets and Heels. Noon to 2. XL Primetime. 2 to 4. The Franchi Show. 4 to 6. Into the Night with Rick Ballew and Hacker After Dark. Evenings on 1010XL.
Hey everybody, it's Mike Dempsey here for Pella Windows and Doors. Look, obviously the warmer temperatures are already here. And if you're like me, you want that oppressive Florida heat to stay outside your house. That's why I'm such a fan of Pella Windows and Doors. By now we know that windows are the number one way that heat gets in and the cold gets out. So when you're ready for the stylish design and energy efficiency that comes from Pella Windows and Doors, visit their showroom on Phillips Highway, just north of Bay Meadows, or you can always find them online at PellaJax.com. That's Pella Windows and Doors.
What makes a Honda certified pre-owned vehicle so special? 182-point inspection, 24/7 roadside assistance, first-year free oil changes, and a 7-year, 100,000-mile warranty for carefree driving backed by American Honda. Visit your local Honda dealer today.
Now that's what I call high-quality H2O.
If you want high-quality water throughout your home, call your local water boy. We install equipment to solve any water problem. Waterboyjax.com.
any adventure, any task, any time. There's a CF Moto Utility ATV or UTV for any rider. See the full lineup at Ride Now Beach Boulevard. Venture seekers can start with the trail-tested capability and comfort of the Z-Force lineup. For the ultimate in UTV performance, check out the Z-Force 950. Find your utility ATV at Ride Now Beach Boulevard or online at cfmotousa.com. ATVs are recommended for the use only by riders age 16 years and older. ATVs can be hazardous to operate. CF Moto recommends approved training course for safety and training information.
Breaking news, Jacksonville. Play It Again Sports is back. We are proud to be opening a brand new store on Merrill Road, but we need your help. We are currently stocking up and we need your gently used sports and fitness equipment. Play It Again Sports offers cash on the spot for all your used gear. We buy baseball, softball, football, hockey, lacrosse, golf, water sports. You name it, we buy it. Turn that gear into cash at Play It Again Sports Jacksonville on Merrill Road near 295 in the Merrill Station Shopping Plaza.
When you hear a great call on 1010XL,
telephone communique,
it's covered by the All-Pro Roofing phone line.
If you'd like any further information, just call me.
Listen for great phone interviews all day on the All-Pro Roofing phone line on 1010XL.
Mueller Air Conditioning presents...
Are You Cool?
Today's challenger, a corporate management manager from Jacksonville, Florida. Meet Les Blankston.
Yeah, hi, Bob.
That is a remarkably beige suit there, Les. Tell us, why are you on the show?
Well, I just replaced my old air conditioner with a new one from Bueller, and I'm just so comfortable these days. I wondered, am I cool now?
Let's find out, Les. Go ahead and spin the wheel.
That's right, Les. By upgrading your old AC to a more energy-efficient model from Bueller Air Conditioning, you'll save money, save energy, and proudly show your family that
you are cool.
Do you think I should get a mohawk?
Pace yourself, Les.
Stay cooler with Bueller.
Visit BuellerAir.com. Need protection? Call Craig and Christine Kaprosky at Goosehead Insurance. The Kaproskys are a husband-wife team committed to finding you the right coverage at the right price in just a few short minutes. For home, auto, flood, or specialty insurance, Craig and Christine Kaprosky are the answer. Craig.Kaprosky at Goosehead.com.
Rick Ballew for Carlson Dental. You know, I've been telling you this for quite some time because it's true. I hate going to the dentist, or at least I used to hate going to the dentist. I had total anxiety. And then I tried sedation, light sedation for cleaning and deep sedation as well for cavities and root canals. Folks, it's an incredible experience. So don't be nervous. Don't be scared. Go to CarlsonDentalGroup.com. That's CarlsonDentalGroup.com for all of your dental needs.
Okay, sports fans, Hicken here. Let's talk skin. I and Beaches Dermatology are reminding you all to wear your sunscreen. Spring is here, and that means more time outside. Grabbing the clubs for your tee time? Bring the screen. Heading out on the boat? Bring the screen. Headed to the beach? Definitely bring the sunscreen. All in all, make sure sunscreen is included in your outdoor activities. If you have any concerns now, give Beaches Dermatology a call. I've been seeing them for years, and my skin thanks me for it. Call today online at BeachesDermatology.com.
This is Keith Catlin for Catlin Truck Accessories, and we are so blessed to be in business for over 100 years. Over 100 years of the best product and customer service means you can count on Catlin. From rolling lock bed covers to Lear toppers to cam locker toolboxes, Catlin Truck Accessories has you covered when it comes to your truck or van. We do those too. Got a fleet of vehicles? We can outfit them all.
Who can you count on? Count on Catlin.
One name, one location, 100 years. You can count on Catlin.
All right, guys, be a true grill master with the Sausage Dudes Sausage and upgrade that cookout. The Sausage Dudes are guys from Jacksonville who use their family recipes to make better sausage with the best cuts of pork, carefully sourced spices, and natural casings. And the Sausage Dudes are mission-minded, supporting the Boys and Girls Club of Northeast Florida. Try all four flavors because your cookout deserves better. Now available at all Publix stores in the frozen meat section. Head to Publix today and get your hands on the Sausage Dudes Sausage.
Andrew Gibson here, sports fans, and the next time you're driving by Kuhn Flowers on Beach Boulevard, why not stop in and smell the roses? Kuhn Flowers has totally changed the face of their store inside and out. Send someone you love a floral arrangement today from Kuhn Flowers.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555. Jacksonville.
let's ring up another guest on the All-Pro Roofing phone line. Now, more Jaguars today on 1010XL.
All right, we continue along today. The big news of the day, Josh Allen signing a five-year, $150 million extension. At least those are the reported numbers. Right now, $30 million a year average with 88 guaranteed, and he'll be a Jaguar for a long time to come. The timing of it, probably the only thing you can critique, but do we know that it could have gotten done any earlier than this with all the conditions that were in place? Let's discuss that and more with our friend Demetrius Harvey of the Florida Times Union. Good morning, Demetrius. How are you?
Good morning. I'm doing well. Dylan asked me to come on Tuesday, and I, you know, delayed it clearly just to come on and talk about the Josh Allen
Thank
extension.
Thank you. Yes. I hope your overlords at the Florida Times Union were serviced with a breaking news story minutes before this was announced.
Absolutely.
Because clearly you were holding on, sir. And no, it worked out. Great timing. We appreciate you coming on this morning. So what about the critique? Well, yeah, but. Why didn't we get it done earlier? Here's the question. With Brian Burns kind of setting that part of the market, right, and Josh Allen coming in just like $500,000 over in guaranteed money, do we know for sure that this deal could have gotten done before the deadline to apply the franchise tag?
We don't know for sure about that. There's been no indications about whether or not they could have come to an agreement before. The only thing we have is sort of rumors, speculation, things of that nature. So to me, it's not necessarily a situation where you're thinking, man, if you just signed him to that deal, then we wouldn't be sitting here today without Calvin Ridley. I think it's mostly the contract didn't get done. And, you know, obviously, if you're Josh Allen and you know that Brian Burns is on the block and Brian Burns is probably about to get paid, why not wait a little bit longer? But obviously that's all pure speculation. We don't really know.
Does the Allen deal getting done make them trading for guys that we've talked about in the past here recently, and Ayuk or a Higgins, does it make that any more likely in your mind?
No. I think that's a completely separate situation. It's the same thing, if the Jaguars are working on an extension with Josh Allen, can they work on an extension with Trevor Lawrence? They can do both. I thought that, being able to get Allen under that, I think it was $24 million in cap space, freeing up some cap space definitely does help in that regard if they do want to make a move like that. But to me, it never felt like or feels like, it was hinging on an extension with Allen as far as trading for anybody. If they're going to trade for a Brandon Ayuk or a T. Higgins, I would imagine that they would have done it regardless, because I don't think that their cap space situation is such that they couldn't make any moves like that without an Allen extension.
Well, I mean, usually when you sign an extension, you lower the cap number. They don't have, and that could be true with Trevor Lawrence or Tyson Campbell or anybody, right? So they don't necessarily need a fresh pot of money to go chase someone that they don't have, right? Because the mass part of free agency is over. So, Demetrius, is it possible that they elect to take a bigger cap hit in year one, right? And then maybe lessen it in future years because they've got, every year is a struggle, right? There are going to be new guys coming up for deals, new guys who are franchise tag candidates, and so on.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, no, I actually thought about that too. And they can easily, use the cap space that they have this year and sort of tie it up to Josh Allen a little bit more. And so, the next few years, perhaps it won't be that large. And you're right, they do have to come to a contract extension with Trevor Lawrence. Obviously, his deal is going to be massive, regardless of what people think about him. And so, you do want to have some cap flexibility in the future, because you know that much of that cap space is going to be tied up into Lawrence's contract. You have Tyson Campbell, you have Andre Sisco, you have guys that could potentially earn new contracts this season. I know they're not necessarily working on a contract extension with Tyson or Andre as of yet, but say they have good seasons and you want to be able to tie up some money into them next year, then lowering Josh Allen's cap space for next season as opposed to this year, when there's not really much to spend it on this year, does make sense to me.
You had Jared Verse as your pick in the mock draft that you put out on Monday over there at the Times Union. Does the deal getting done with Josh Allen, if Jared Verse is available when you're picking at 17 next Monday, is that the same direction you would go with that pick?
Yeah, no, it changes it completely. So I think I put it in my story. The logic there was, you know, say Josh Allen and the Jaguars couldn't come to an agreement for any reason. There could have been any number of shortfalls that occur because these contract extensions are so complex. Say they don't come to an agreement before the season. You're sitting there with 1 year left on Josh Allen, you know, a couple years left on Trayvon Walker, and you don't really have much pass rush to depend on if Allen leaves in free agency the next season. So, yeah, you know, my logic was completely hinged on the fact that they might not get to an extension with Allen, and being able to select Burse would make sense as insurance, as a negotiation ploy. I kind of viewed it similarly to last year when the Jaguars drafted Brenton Strange in the second round. Now, would they have drafted Strange, you know, regardless, you know, if they had had an extension with Ingram before? I don't know. But, you know, it did point to me, you know, hey, they're giving themselves insurance in case Ingram can't come to an agreement and then he's going to leave the following season after playing on the tag. So, yeah, I hinge it all on that. And I still do think that it would be it wouldn't be a prudent move considering all of their other needs to go pass rusher at that pick.
Yeah, I'm with you on that. There's just no real path to Jared Verse starting anytime soon on this football team. And I think that's Brenton Strange was a late second round pick. And not only that, they traded back and accumulated more. So they got paid off for doing that. So, and again, Osiris Torrance was sitting there. We don't have to go back over it. A lot of us would have taken him. Wouldn't have been the way, but it's more understandable to go for that in that circumstance, like you're talking about, with the late second rounder than it is with the 17th pick. They got to get a walk-in starter here. What do they do if they're not going to go early for pass rush here, Demetrius? What is the depth? Like, who do you think right now is the best bet to be the third most effective edge rusher in the rotation? I'm not talking about Eric Armstead or Roy Robertson-Harris, like inside guys who might put up some numbers. Who's the next edge up in the pecking order?
Yeah, it's still lacking. They brought in Travis Gibson, who's had a middling career so far. You know, that seven sack season is still the hallmark, and it was a couple years ago. So, you know, I do think that he's probably the next man up. But Yasir Abdullah is another guy that they like a lot, and I understand that this team might not fit for him. But we'll have to let it play out. Right now, yeah, you know, their depth is still significantly poor. But you know, at 17, it still would be a situation where I feel like the resources are better spent elsewhere. I feel like, you know, go ahead and draft a guy in the second round or draft a guy in the third round. That makes sense. Spending it on a first round pick just doesn't make sense as much to me anymore.
We've gone over the process with Josh Allen going back to last season plenty. Do you expect the team to make Tyson Campbell any kind of contract offer this offseason? And what do you think would be a fair offer for him?
Yeah, I view that similarly to the Josh Allen situation where, to me, you know, if I were the Jaguars, I would want to make a contract extension offer to Tyson Campbell now because, you know, you can get him probably significantly cheaper than you would before. But if you're Tyson Campbell, you know, why wouldn't you want to just go ahead and bet on yourself, you know, instead of making maybe around what DJ Reed made from the Jets at like $33 million over a few years, maybe, you know, now you can parlay that into something that, you know, maybe Trevon Diggs makes, you know, $76 million if you have a great season. So to me, I feel like there's so much of a gap for Tyson to earn that, you know, just go ahead and play this season out and sort of negotiate on the contract next year. I don't feel like a contract extension for Tyson is going to happen this offseason. I don't think that the Jaguars have made that clear at all. And I know for a fact that, you know, at least for Andre Sisco's situation, they haven't even started those negotiations. So to me, I feel like that's not something that'll happen before the season.
And I think what you're describing is very plausibly something similar that could have happened with Josh Allen last year.
Yeah.
We like to pay you now that you're coming off 3 years in which you totaled about 17 sacks. We'd like to pay you something a little bit less than this $30 million figure. And Josh is probably like, you know, this is not the time to sign the long-term deal. right? I mean, I saw a thing, I think it was SI did it, we were looking at yesterday, Demetrius, where they projected the top 25 potential free agents based on, like Trevor Lawrence is on the list. We know he'll never be a free agent next year. But right now, his contract only runs through this year, right? They haven't picked up the fifth-year option, so he's technically eligible to be on this list. He was number one in the entire league. Tyson Campbell didn't even make this 25-man list. Three corners were on there ahead of him. So I wonder what, like right now, what would his market value be? I think he's seen as a good young player, but not a great young player, you know? So I think you're exactly right. If Tyson Campbell wants the big, big cornerback money, he's going to have to bet on himself. And, you know, we don't know those conversations. And some people will take it as, well, Balky couldn't get it done again, or Balky's waiting too long again. He's gonna roll the dice again and cost us more money. We don't know this whole process. For all we know, Josh Allen's had a big smile on his face going, I'm going to get paid. I know it's getting closer. I'm not worried about it, whether it's, you know, March, April, May, June, July. At least I don't have that kind of level of detail.
Yeah, no, I completely agree with you. You know, and Josh had sent out a tweet, and he might have deleted it or something, but he had sent out a tweet a while ago, you know, people trying to play online GM. And perhaps that was something, you know, to signal to us, hey, you know, this is getting done, don't worry, you know, it's going smoothly. We all speculate about this kind of stuff.
Right. And we have no idea what that meant. Yeah, exactly.
I completely agree with you, though, in the sense of, yeah, perhaps Josh Allen did, you know, bet on himself last year. He said, no, we're not going to negotiate a contract. There's no reason to. I wouldn't be, you know, paid as highly as I value myself. And, yeah, that is a perfect example of a player who wants to bet on himself, and then it paid off. And I do feel like Tyson Campbell fits under that same boat. When you miss, you know, six games last season, you have soft tissue injuries. You had a poor or at least so-so rookie season, and the only season you've had a good year at was in 2022. I do understand, you know, on both sides, hey, you know, if you're the Jaguars, can you invest that much money into a guy you don't know will even be healthy and stay on the field? You haven't seen him in your defense at all. You know, how will that impact his play, things of that nature. And then from Tyson's side, yeah, you haven't had the productive seasons that would warrant a big contract extension, and he's not ignorant to that. I'm sure his agent isn't. So, yeah, I do feel as though, you know, Tyson's time is coming, but probably not this year.
All right, Demetrius Harvey, in addition to all his other fine work, go check out the mock draft for the Jaguars that he posted on Monday, I believe it was. And I'm not a fan of drafting a running back this year, Demetrius, but I did at least appreciate your explanation on the pandering to the Frank Gore contingent out there for what he has meant to this franchise, that we would take Gore Jr. in round 7. So if it happens that way, I won't hate it. But other than that, let's not draft any more running backs, please, sir. All right.
Absolutely.
Great work, man. 2 weeks to go. You know we'll be calling on you probably a couple more times before then, but thanks for the time this morning.
Absolutely. I appreciate you guys.
All right, brother. Demetrius Harvey, at Demetrius82 out there on Twitter or X, and go check out his work at Jacksonville.com and in the Florida Times Union. Coming up next, John Osier, who, if you're watching on the YouTube channel, you saw stride confidently into the studio right there. John was doing the nice thing. He was waiting so he didn't have to cross in front of the camera. Come on in, Osh. It's all in the family here. So we got an hour to go. Johnny O will weigh in on Josh Allen, as will you. If you want to get back into the phone call circuit, 641-1010 on the All-Pro Roofing phone lines. This is Jaguars Today on 1010XL and 92.5 FM.
It's another Weight Loss Wednesday. Awaken 180 Weight Loss in the Jacksonville Orthopedic Institute studios, where the pros go. Sometimes you make bad decisions.
Tell me, so what's the charge?
Disturbing the peace.
And sometimes you make good decisions.
It says here we should work in teams. Who wants to be my spotter?
1010XL, when you want to make a good decision.
Hey, Hicken here. I couldn't be any happier than to join the George Moore Chevrolet family. When I say family, I mean it. Visit their beautiful showroom today off Atlantic Boulevard. Find out exactly what I'm talking about. No pressure, just friendly help. And whether you want a car, a truck, SUV, electric, pre-owned, you name it, George Moore Chevrolet has it. If you can't make it over to Atlantic Boulevard, no problem. MooreChevy.com is easy to navigate as any site you will try. It's never been more easy to use. George Moore Chevrolet. Together, let's drive.
It's Kubota Orange Days, your golden chance to score a deal that will make your neighbors green with envy. Shop the year's best selection of Kubota tractors, zero-turn mowers, and utility vehicles, including the number one selling compact tractor in the USA. And get the year's best deals, like 0% APR for 84 months or up to $3,300 off L3302 tractors. Coastal Equipment on New Kings Road and in McClenny. Coastal
Equipment. David here with Royal Pest Services. Man, don't let your yard be torn up by that heavy aeration machine this spring. Visit royalpestservices.com to learn more about our granular aeration, broadcast throughout the tree and shrubs to break up that compacted soil. Visit royalpestservices.com.
The flagship station of the Jacksonville Jaguars. WJXL AM Jacksonville Beach. WJXL FM Jacksonville Beach.
Beards Diamond's most popular sale is back.
All wedding bands are buy one, get one free.
Plus all stackables, all right hand rings, all eternity bands, and more are buy one, get one free.
At the St. John's Town Center or at beardsdiamonds.com.
Dave Binion here with my son Ammon, who is the air duct cleaning manager at Zero Res. So Ammon, you may notice a little rattle in my voice and some puffiness in my eyes. That's because allergy season is coming on. Can Zero Res help?
Yes. Your health has a lot to do with the air you breathe. A clean and healthy home begins with clean air. At Zero Res, we can help clean the air in your home by cleaning your air ducts, cleaning the coils in your HVAC units, and fogging the system with a powerful antimicrobial that helps kill and control the growth of microorganisms in your air. We also have options for maintaining your clean air with our excellent inline air purifier and UV lights that will help keep your system clean and healthy. At Zero Res, we are more than just air duct cleaners. We're a clean air specialist.
Have Zero Res air duct specialists out, and right now we'll give you $50 off your air duct cleaning, and while we're at it, we'll give you $50 off your dryer vent cleaning. Zero Res.
Spelled forward or backwards, it's the right way to clean.
C-E-R-O-R-E-C. Zero Res.
Whether you're in need of a simple AC repair or it's time to upgrade your HVAC system, Duck Duck Air Conditioning is here to help. Give us a call today to schedule an estimate, 904-862-6769, or online at duckduckac.com.
It doesn't get any better than live country music. Enjoy Daryl Ray at Players Grill Miramar this Friday at 7 p.m. with discount cocktails while the local star rocks out. Players Grill Miramar, where the neighborhood meets.
This is my bar.
Packer here with another unbelievable stat. I'm now down 45 pounds in just 6 weeks with Awaken 180 weight loss. 45 pounds, and I basically just started the program. I wasn't always this walking advertisement for feeling good. Let's just say the struggle was real. Tried everything. Programs, diets, and yes, even those injections. Sure, I lost a few pounds, but the results were so slow. Top that with not feeling myself, coupled with needing shots for the rest of my life? No thanks. Thank you. It's not just the 45-pound number. Even though, yeah, that's unbelievable. It's about life, man. I took Little Hack to SeaWorld last week. Walked around all day, no sweat, no being tired. 2 months ago, I would have skipped out on that whole experience. If it's time for you to drop some weight like it was for me, do what I did. Go to awaken180weightloss.com or call 844-346-1800. That's 844-346-1800. It's Awaken 180 Weight Loss.
This is Molly McDonald with your 1010XL Southeast Orthopedic Specialist Local Sports Update, brought to you by Awaken 180. The Seminoles baseball team completed the season sweep against the Gators after a dominating 19-4 victory in Tallahassee last night. Seminoles head coach Link Jarrett says his players were locked in and ready for go in this top rivalry matchup.
I don't even know where to start offensively. The guys were just locked in. They were locked in, and really from the first at-bat of the game, until they were probably in six, wasn't what we wanted, but geez, that's hard to do, and I'm proud of the way the guys handled this.
Jaguars Pro Bowl pass rusher Josh Allen has agreed to his 5-year, $150 million deal with $88 million guaranteed. Allen becomes one of the highest paid edge rushers in the NFL. It's 77 degrees at 11 o'clock, time and temp brought to you by Bueller Air Conditioning. Stay cooler with Bueller.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555, Jacksonville.
O'Knows with Jaguars.com's John Osher. Brought to you by
Kingfish Pest Control, proud partner of the Jacksonville Jaguars.
On 1010XL.
All right, Tony, I'd like to report my car is back.
All right.
My friend Rich has retrieved his golf shoes from my house.
Yeah.
And I do not have to make a madcap dash for the house and get back to the first tee. On time.
There have been Benny Hill music over that madcap.
It would have been madcap. All right. It would have been zany, John. Zany. It would have been very entertaining for all to see. I'm glad that we don't have to see that. Good morning, John Osher.
Guys, how are we?
We're not as good as Josh Allen.
No, Josh is having a good morning.
Josh is having a good day. I think Trent Baalke's probably having not as good a day. He's not spending his money.
Yeah, I mean,
it's a good day for Shot. It's a good day to spend $150 million.
Well, it's deserved, and as I'm sure has been said here before, Josh, I thought last year would, you know, I've always thought that he should be signed to a long-term deal. I get why the sides waited. Good guy, and, you know, I think with Josh, what you see is what you get. And I think he's a guy that you like having locked up. He's a guy you liked having drafted, representing your franchise, all those things. I'm happy for him.
All right. I think most people are. Even the bulky detractors are like, you know, I'm happy that we have Josh Allen, but why couldn't we have gotten this done earlier and been able to apply the franchise tag to Calvin Ridley if we had wanted to go that way? Don't know, by the way, that if they had done that, if the math all works out, that they'd still be able to sign Arik Armstead, because I know they had a plan to sign Ridley to a deal, and that might have been a very low initial year cap figure.
Right.
And so when you transfer, if you were to take Josh Allen, whatever his cap hit's going to be, add it to the $22 million on the franchise tag of Ridley's number, even though it's less than Allen's franchise tag number, whatever Allen's making is probably more than the $2 million difference, right? Or at least what he's counting.
Okay.
So it might have put you in a position where you had to choose between Ridley and Armstead. Possibly. We don't know.
Why didn't it get done before? Sides weren't ready to get it done.
Well, you know,
and
to be fair to – there are plenty of Baalke detractors, and there's plenty of fair criticism of Trent Baalke, okay? The main one being, well, wait, we found out that for a couple weeks after the season, he didn't even contact Allen's side. So I'm playing devil's advocate a bit here. Could the deal have been sped up? Could we have gotten this done before the franchise tag deadline, which, by the way, was – over a month ago.
Right.
So beyond that 2-week window, but could that have sped the process up? I don't know the answer to that.
I don't know either. My thought is always that most of the big movement on these things is forced by a deadline, and that you're going to get more done in a day than you would have in 6 weeks because the deadline's approaching. That could be wrong, too.
Because this isn't a deadline deal, right? No. I mean, the deadline's July now.
Yeah.
Right. At this point.
Still had time before the next deadline to get this done. But talking about the deadline.
Well, I meant in terms of that March 5th date.
Yeah.
That if anything was going to get done before that.
Like, how much pressure did you sense there was for them to get that deal done leading into that deadline to use the tag? Was it close?
My impression was that Trent didn't feel like that had to happen, I think is what you're asking.
Mm-hmm.
I think they wanted to, but I think they knew that a contract – my impression is they knew that a contract of this size there's a couple of contracts that are going to determine their cap more than any others for the next X number of years, and that's Trevor and Josh's. I would assume these are going to be the big cap-eating contracts. I think there was a thought that we need to make sure these are right and these are fit while we're moving forward, and that's more important than this short-term deadline.
Well, Foye Luikin is done. Josh Allen is done. We don't know about Tyson Campbell. It could be, as we were talking with Demetrius Harvey,
I'd be very surprised if that's this offseason.
Right, because for the reasons we laid out, that that Tyson might feel like, well, my value isn't where it could be.
And he feels that way, and I think it's fair for the team to not know what they want to pay him.
To not give him, like, top five corner money. He hasn't been a top five corner.
And man, top five corner, injured last year. It's a business.
And I'm using top five as just an example. It could be top 10 or
whatever. I think Tyson's a player that, yeah, I like him. I like him as a player when he's on. But I don't think he's a top five corner. I don't think anybody does.
And no, I agree with you.
To pay him that, especially coming off a year where a hamstring kept you down, look, we like you, but we got to see it.
And while Tony has been very open about it, he would have paid Josh Allen last offseason.
Right.
Josh Allen was not a top five pass rusher going into this past year. He just wasn't.
It would have been difficult for either side to get that done last offseason.
Yeah.
I said all last offseason I would have paid him.
But paid him what?
I would not have paid. Right. I would have liked to have seen him long-term tied up for the Jaguars last offseason. If somebody had said, yes, but you have to pay him
$30 million a year average. Yeah, right, right.
Formula is, you have to pay him like he's a top three pass rusher. Well, I can't do that. You know, and I think Josh would have said, well, I wouldn't expect him to do that.
And that was one.
I'm not there yet.
Some people would call up throughout this process and say, pay him whatever he wants. Okay.
Okay.
And then I would just say, all right, he wants $40 million. Well, I'm not going to pay that. Okay, so you have a limit.
Right.
That means it's okay for Trent Baalke to have a
limit.
It's not,
because he's Trent.
Exactly. Right. And that's what it comes down to. Like, why wasn't this done? Because you don't want to pay him 30 if you can pay him 22.
Right.
And you don't want to take 30 if you think you can get 35.
Right.
Right. So it ultimately, and I think that this is a super fair deal based on the market conditions. He's a little bit more productive than Brian Burns. He's going to get just a tick more. He's not been Nick Bosa.
Mm-mm.
And he's not going to get Nick Bosa money, but he's going to get, right now, I think he's the second highest paid guy potentially at the position. Am I wrong? Right?
You know, it's called now, it's called Josh Allen money.
Right. T.J. Watt wants some of that Josh Allen money now, and he's going to get it.
Second in the position,
too.
And I think third moment, among right? non-quarterbacks in the league.
Third among, so who would be, who else? Tyreek?
Yeah, Tyreek was up there, okay. But I haven't seen the whole list.
And in a year, he'll be 15th.
Maybe so. Right?
But
that's the way that works.
Yeah, that's the way it works. I mean,
if Josh Allen goes and has 11 sacks this year, what an idiot Baalke is for giving him $30 million, yeah. Right? Like on a one-year explosion, had to know this was coming. That's coming too.
It's all good.
I'm just happy Josh Allen. I'm happy he's here. He's locked in. There's no more question about that. Now, you can retroactively question about the timing, and I'm hoping that when Josh Allen eventually, I don't know if it's going to be as quick as Foye Oluokun was or if it's going to be like at the next minicamp when he shows up, but when he addresses that media, we're going to ask, you know, do you think this could have got done, or is he just going to say, hey, I leave all that up to my agent?
My expectation is to be the latter because it usually is. I think the thing with Josh that makes this safe is this. I have no idea how many sacks he'll get next year. What I don't think you're ever going to get from him, if he has 10, it won't be because he didn't prepare.
You're going to get full effort.
Yeah, which, you know, and full buy-in, et cetera.
Which seems bar, right? But I understand where you're coming from on
so
this.
So I don't think as a GM you ever have to put your head on the pillow worrying about what guy is going to show up.
Some guys would get $88 million guaranteed and be like, I'm set for life. That's guaranteed. Do whatever I want.
Well, you're looking at
him. Right? I'm looking in the mirror then. Okay? And that's why we don't get 80. Because they know better. Right. All right? Johnny Oge is here. Johnny Oge. I just kind of went right in the middle.
Right.
Johnny Oge with us. If you'd like to get in.
Not trying.
We'll open up. I'm just not trying. John, after today, I'm off till Monday. All right? So really, I've checked out. Let's be honest. If you'd like to get in and express your opinion on the Jaguars and Josh Allen getting a new five-year deal done, we'll reopen the phone lines to you. We had them buzzing earlier in the program. Now's your time to weigh in on whatever angle about this deal you want to talk about, what it means for the future, whatever. We're just not going to break down. You know, we're not in draft mode today. We're on the Josh Allen train today. So 641-1010 on the All-Pro Roofing phone lines or the text line. Designed by Lifetime Enclosures. If you'd like to hop in, we'd love to have you. Mike Dempsey, Tony Smith, John Oge, and Dylan Denmark here with you on 1010XL and 92.5 FM.
Yeah, Josh will be a Jaguar.
Jaguars today from the Jacksonville Orthopedic Institute studios.
It's a weight loss Wednesday on 1010XL. Awaken 180 Weight Loss, your long-term solution for weight loss.
But first, let's meet our contestants. Behind curtain number one,
Dan Hicken and Jeff Prosser. The Drill, mornings on 1010XL.
Imagine driving a late model Corvette, BMW, Mercedes, Lexus, Honda, Chevy, Ford, and more, all at a fraction of the original sticker price. Visit Vaughn Motor Group's indoor showroom and browse a great selection of dream cars that are inspected with warranties. Before you make your next auto purchase, check out Vaughn Motor Group on San Jose Boulevard or at VaughnMotorGroup.com for a complete inventory listing. If you can dream it, you can drive it at Vaughn Motor Group.
Joe C for CSS Fireplaces and Outdoor Living. They can transform your backyard with fire pits, pergolas, screen enclosures, and outdoor kitchens. And CSS handles the entire project from start to finish. You dream it, they build it. CSSOutdoor.com.
At Duck Duck Rooter, we understand plumbing issues can be a real inconvenience for your building or business, and we're here to help. We can handle all kinds of plumbing jobs, including broken pipes, clogged drains, line jetting, installing water heaters, and full repipes. Need a camera inspection or a smoke test? Yes, Duck Duck Rooter does that too. Plus, our lift station services include inspections, monitoring, cleaning, and repairs. When you're stuck, call the Duck. 904-862-6769. That's 904-862-6769.
Crosser here. When it comes to the business of selling your home, there's one promise I can give you that will deliver, and that promise is ChadAndSandy.com. That's Chad, A-N-D, Sandy.com. How do I know this promise is guaranteed? Because they say so, and then they deliver. You see, Chad and Sandy guarantee your home sold at an agreed-upon price and deadline, or they will buy it. So whatever problems you think you're having selling your home, there is your simple solution. They're going to buy it if it's not sold for exactly what you want. Mortgage rates have lowered going into the spring selling season. Now is the time to maximize your equity, and you can do it with the real estate team of Chad and Sandy. They have a plan and the experience to sell your home fast for maximum cash this spring. John and Ursula in Green Meadows wrote in, we weren't in great health, decided to downsize to an easier place to manage. After 185 days, our home failed to sell. We went to Chad and Sandy, sold in 12 days. You can too at ChadAndSandy.com.
Jumbo Shrimp Baseball, presented by FIS, is home all week at 1-1 Financial Ballpark. Tomorrow is Coors Light Thirsty Thursday with beer specials, then it's Red Shirt Friday with fireworks, and the first 2,000 fans on Saturday get free Jumbo Shrimp pajama pants, plus more fireworks. Baseball all week and weekend with tickets starting at just $5. Log on to jackshrimp.com for tickets. Jumbo Shrimp Baseball, affordable, family fun.
It's the blog players put their pads on for.
So we want it, we got to bring it.
My thoughts and observations on our home team, that's what I share with you every week on my blog.
Roland Reich Plumbing brings you Hayes Blog on 1010XL.com.
Keeping your body healthy and active leads to a more vibrant life. A great place to do that is the First Coast YMCA. The Y is equipped with state-of-the-art cardio and strength equipment, plus group exercise studios where trainers host activities like yoga, Zumba, and cycling sessions. The full-court basketball gym and indoor five-lane swimming pool are open year-round. The Kid Zone can keep an eye on your kids while you work on that dad bod. And it's all available with your family membership. Learn more at fcymca.org.
Imagine waking up this time next week and being 100% debt-free. No credit cards, no car loan, no personal loans. Hey, it's Prosser here, and Loan Pronto's Equity Express line of credit can make that happen. Homeowners are turning their home equity into cash almost instantly. With Loan Pronto's AI-based system, you can get approval in about 10 minutes with almost no documentation, no appraisal, and no hassle. You can get hundreds of thousands of dollars out of your home. Use that money to pay off all your other loans. The average homeowner saves over $850 a month doing this. Listen, your home value's way up. You can use that to wipe out all those credit cards, get some money for a home improvement. Literally, hundreds of thousands are at your fingertips, and approval is just minutes away. So call now, 904-999-1508. 904-999-1508. That's loanpronto.com at 904-999-1508. NMLS 1661781, subject to lender approval, equal housing lender.
Who holds the record for the most consecutive field goals made in the NBA? The answer next.
Having the right homeowners policy protection means you're staying on top of your most valuable possession, your home. For information on finding an agent, go to southernoak.com.
Our family protecting yours, Southern Oak Insurance.
Over a four-game stretch in 1967, Wilt Chamberlain made 35 consecutive field goals.
Southern Oak Insurance, our family protecting yours.
Hello, this is Father Nicholas Lowe, and I want to talk to you about not being afraid of the crosses of life. Life can be difficult. Maybe today you're carrying a cross of worry or stress. Let me encourage you to remember that when Christ got on the big cross at Golgotha, he destroyed all the little crosses that we face in our life. He set us free from fear, worry, and anxiety. Our job is not to be carried by the cross, but to be carried by our faith.
For more inspiration, log on to stjohnthedivine.com.
Hey, it's Tony from Tony D's Pizza. If you love our pizza and pasta dishes, let us cater an event for you. Family function or office parties, we can deliver you an amazing Italian meal. Remember, it's not just pizza at Tony D's. Bay Meadows and 295.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555. Jacksonville.
Oh, no's.
With Jaguars.com's John Osher.
Brought to you by
Kingfish Pest Control, proud partner of the Jacksonville Jaguars on 1010XL.
All right, here we go. Johnny O in the house. Going to go around the league here coming up, take more of your calls. If you want to react to the Jaguars and Josh Allen getting a five-year deal done, I see that a report that there's optimism that Antoine Winfield and the Bucks will agree on a new contract. He's on the franchise tag. Of course there is. Mm-hmm. Trent Baalke to show you how to get
That's
it
right.
done.
That's right.
Come on, Jason Light. So what? That Super Bowl ring means nothing to me. Okay. Finally, I mean, why are we letting Antoine Winfield languish like this? Seems like bad business to me, but that's the Bucks. Terribly run organization, right? He says, tongue firmly planted in cheek. Let's go to our friend Regina up next here on Jaguars Today. Good morning, Regina.
Good morning.
What's
up?
Good
morning, guys. I'm glad. I'm happy for Josh and his family. He made it clear he wanted to stay. They would like to hear number two, Calvin Ridley was not worth what the Titans have paid for him. And number three, I wanted to ask Johnny O, what does he think the message is with the locker room, in the locker room for this, you know, sealing the deal? And I'll take your comments off the air.
All right, Regina, thank you. Do you think there's a message that this sends to the locker room, this deal?
I think it's a message that Josh Allen's a good player.
That he deserved the money, right? Yeah. Like, we were talking about that on the break.
Yeah.
You know, people say, what kind of message does it send when you franchise tag Josh Allen? You don't.
Yeah.
Quote, reward him with a contract that he clearly earned. Well, he got it.
Right.
And like, if the next guy, like when Eric Armstead gets offered $51 million for 3 years, does he go, but
yeah,
you haven't finished the Josh Allen deal yet? No,
right.
He doesn't even
does,
think about it.
It right. does feel like Josh Allen is a good enough player and teammate that everyone in that room is going to celebrate Josh getting
that
done.
They'll be happy, sure.
Right? Like, they're going to be happy that Josh got it done. The franchise figured it out with that guy. They wanted him to be around. Right? Like, I think that's going to be the reaction of the room. I don't know how much of a long-term effect that has on the next guy getting it. Like, I don't think that affects Tyson Campbell's contract at all.
No, but you know what it could do?
But it doesn't mean Tyson isn't happy for Josh.
Right. You know what it could do, Tony? It just it avoids having a situation like Ramsey and Jan kind of percolating the dissatisfaction of we want to get paid. We want to get paid now. Mm. When, you know, when are we going to get ours? Me.
Jan,
Josh Allen, I'm sure, has wanted his.
Over and over and over.
I know they did. I totally get that as well. But what happened was
it became a narrative.
It became a narrative, right? And there was an undercurrent of dissatisfaction of when am I going to get mine? And led by Jalen Ramsey.
Mm-hmm.
There's no one to lead that. Now. You know what I mean? Like,
right.
if Josh Allen did play on the franchise tag, there could have been some. Like, really?
Yeah.
Like, what do you have to do to get a contract around here? Despite the fact that Evan Engram got a contract, Foye got a contract, Cam Robinson's gotten contract after getting franchise tag, Devon Hamilton got a big deal last year, Trevor's going to get a massive deal. Still, that issue is a non-issue now. It's it's more that it removed the potential for a little dissent than it's going to, I think, change anything for the positive.
It's certainly not why you do it.
Of course.
So.
Of course. Dilla tweeting in, I think Allen and Armstead have the same agent, too. So that's – and I think he's looking at it from the standpoint of certainly didn't – it's not like Armstead's agent said, hey, they're not paying Josh Allen. You can't take this. You know what I mean? Right?
Right.
So I think that's his point here. Like, people are going to take your money if you offer them enough of it. Right? Yeah. And Josh Allen's the same, by the way. He got his, and now it shouldn't be an issue. Now, here's the one thing about the Ridley deal that Regina brought up. Titans paid him a ridiculous amount. Well, apparently the Jags weren't going to pay him that. Like, if the Titans never made Ridley an offer, the Jags had an offer that Ridley was going to take, mm-hmm. according to the reporting. It was less than that. So they were going to get a better deal than what Tennessee had to pay to retain Ridley if Tennessee wasn't in the mix, right?
Yes.
And that they had a limit that they were probably willing to go to, and they were not willing to meet Tennessee. So they had a limit. Mm-hmm. So when we say, well, Tennessee overpaid him, we wouldn't have been paying Ridley that. You know, we would have had, I think, a more, I don't know how much more team-friendly, but the sense was it was somewhere around $20 million. And
that's what all the reporting was. Yeah.
Right, and you could manage a cap hit in year one. So, again, that's the perfect world. We don't always live in the perfect world.
Nope.
Pretty good outcome today overall. Let's find out what's happening in the less interesting rest of the National Football League.
Now, gems around the NFL, brought to you by Beach's Jewelry and Pawn in Jack's Beach.
The Philadelphia Eagles' week one opponent in Sao Paulo, Brazil, will be the Green Bay Packers. It'll be on that Friday night of week one and streamed exclusively on Peacock. Seattle hosted wide receiver Chase Claypool for a visit on Tuesday. Claypool was a second-round pick by the Steelers in 2020. He caught 121 passes there during his first two seasons, with 11 touchdowns, including 9 as a rookie, and was then traded to the Chicago Bears for the 32nd overall pick in the 2023 NFL Draft. He caught 18 passes in 10 games for Chicago before being traded for a second time last year to Miami in a swap of late-round picks. And cornerback Logan Ryan, a 2-time Super Bowl champion with the New England Patriots, announced his retirement after 11 seasons in the NFL yesterday. He played for New England, Tennessee, the Giants, Tampa, and San Francisco in his career.
To an obscure, tiny percentage of the NFL and even a tiny percentage of the people who play fantasy football, Logan Ryan was a cheat code.
Yes, he was.
Because Logan Ryan played safety and was listed as a cornerback for years. And if you play in these crazy deep leagues like Tony and I play, where you actually play corners and safeties and all that, safeties generally produce more tackles, you know, more the stats that you're going to get
scoring
points for.
Stats, yeah.
And you can stick one in at the, quote, cornerback position. Logan Ryan was like a little, oh, I loved Logan Ryan back in the day, man. You know, little simple things that that make me happy. John asked Demetrius Harvey this, and he said it changed his opinion considerably. Mine is changed to a degree as well. Tony's not as much. With this signing now, Josh Allen is locked up here for the next 5 years. Trayvon Walker is presumably here for at least the next three, right? And you got this year.
Sure.
Right, you get the fourth year and then the fifth year option, minimum. Does this change the calculus? Like, you know, Demetrius had mocked Jared Verse to the Jags with that 17th pick on Monday, said doesn't think that's a good move now because there's no starting job available for an edge rusher in the foreseeable future. Does that change the calculus on how early they're likely to go? Or could go.
With edge rusher?
Yes.
Not mine, because I haven't really thought that that's a position. Considering other things, I'd be shocked if it's number 17, but I would have been shocked if it was number 17
You would
17
have been
before.
Shocked previously. Gotcha.
So it doesn't change that. Maybe it changes a little of, you know, I still think if there's one available at 48 that you love, I think you still take that. Because I guess I've assumed all along that they'd figure out a way for him to be here. So it doesn't change mine, because I never really considered very much that he wouldn't be.
Let me ask you this then. How would you feel? They did add Eric Armstead, so we're anticipating better push from the inside, mm-hmm. which can sometimes lead for better numbers for the guys on the outside. If you had Josh Allen, Trayvon Walker, Travis Gibson as your top three, hopefully you get something out of Yasir Abdullah, and maybe no pick in the first four rounds. Do you have enough this year, barring a wave of injuries?
I don't know, but I think there's a school of thought that sometimes you have to go forward with that. You drafted Abdullah thinking he was going to be a guy. Like
can he turn into that guy?
Yeah. At some point, if you're going to draft these guys and say you're a draft and develop team, they have to develop. So in theory, that's what you should do. Do they have the confidence in the two guys behind Trayvon and Josh that they can do it? We haven't seen it yet. So I wouldn't be surprised if they don't trust those two guys because we haven't seen them do that. So I wouldn't be surprised if it's a third-round pick. I guess I'd be surprised, wouldn't be shocked. I think
so
third round.
You were just less likely that they're going to go edge early anyway, and it just that's kind of where.
Yeah,
you're still at.
Think offensive lineman and wide receiver make sense in round two and three, because at some point, you have to get better and stouter on the offensive line because you're not going to have the whole bunch back for 25.
I don't disagree with that, but I do think with the exception of guy like Verstone, mm-hmm. or I don't know how they feel about Latu
yeah.
you know, out of UCLA. Like, if it's truly a premier, like Jared Verse, some people think will go in the top 10. And if he's there at 17, even though that wouldn't have made the most sense
to me.
That's
the intrigue I had about it on Monday.
It. Yeah.
Right. Like,
if you build up line and offensive line,
yeah.
defensive line and offensive line, if you're getting good players for this team, zero problem with that. At 17
that's the rationale for my opinion on it not changing much. It's because I felt the same way about that. It's like, I think that's a really good value. Because
he's an elite player.
Right, of that player at that spot in the draft. Like, I feel the same way about that today as I did yesterday, despite Josh being here. So if that's the direction it would wind up going, I'd be okay with it.
One of these guys, and it happens every year to several guys, but like we do see – Verse mock sometimes to the Falcons at 8, sometimes to the Bears at 9.
Yeah.
Very conceivable. Also see him mocked in the early 20s.
Yeah.
And because
he's that guy this year. You're
and it depends on what you need, right? Pass rush usually is a high commodity, but a lot of quarterbacks going to go, it appears, maybe 5 of them before the Jags pick, possibly. Offensive line's always a top priority, getting that left tackle, corner, wide receiver. And so it's rich with all those positions right now, so
and there's probably a few teams that are in situations as the Jags. I think they're in a situation at corner where it's going to be tough not to take that spot, even if you love a guy somewhere else, because to me it looks like a glaring need.
It is a glaring need, I think. But at the same time, if you better love that guy as much as you love those other positions. You know, like I don't settle for the fourth best corner because he's the next corner.
Right. What you're saying is philosophically true. It can be hard to stick to.
I understand that, right? And I agree with that because teams that swear their best player available and that's all they are liars, right?
Why would they say anything else?
Right.
Yeah.
That's all they say.
Yeah, well, he was our best, highest graded player on the board.
Yeah.
That's why there are teams always, that stick to it more than others.
Because we factored in what position he plays and we bumped his grade.
Right.
But anyway.
It's a need BAP axis.
Yes, it is. Exactly. Which best player available do we need for this team? All right. One more segment with John Osier from Jaguars.com, the senior writer. If you want to weigh in with your reaction to the Jags getting the deal done with Josh Allen, you're certainly welcome to. It's 641-1010 on the All-Pro Roofing phone lines or the text line designed by Lifetime Enclosures. We'll take a look at some of your reaction on social media when we return. This is Jaguars Today on 1010XL. 92.5 FM. Hey, folks, Mike Dempsey here for Awaken 180 Weight Loss. You want to be the next Awaken 180 success story? All you have to do is give them a call. I'm telling you, the program, I have so much confidence in it that if you try it and stick to what they're coaching you to do, you will have success. It is that simple. 98% success satisfaction rating from the customers from Awaken 180. Why do I think it's only 98? Probably the other 2% didn't stick to the formula because, trust me, the pounds were falling off me. They fell off Matt Hayes. They fell off Hacker. And the key is once they come off, you can keep them off because Awaken 180 has developed a program with great coaching and support that is free for life once you hit your goal weight. Start today. Call 844-346-1800. That's 844-346-1800. You have to lose 10 pounds, 20 pounds, 50, 100 or more. It does not matter. The formula will work for you. That's Awaken 180 Weight Loss. Start eating to lose weight today. That's the promise. You can go online and get on board at Awaken180WeightLoss.com.
It's a Weight Loss Wednesday on Jaguars Today from the JOI Studios. Awaken 180 Weight Loss, your long-term solution for weight loss. Now, another classic moment in Jags history.
There he goes, Jimmy Smith. No flags. Touchdown, Jacksonville. 70 yards.
1010XL, home of the Jaguars.
Gator fans, get ready. The Orange and Blue game is back on Saturday, April 13th at 1 p.m. in the Swamp, and entry is free. This year, Florida Victorious is proud to sponsor the game, and we have tons of new excitement in store for you, like our player meet and greet and autograph session after the game on Steve Spurrier Field. As a member of Florida Victorious, you can visit with players on the team, including Mertz and Lagway. Don't miss out on FanFest, which begins at 10 a.m. on the North Lawn. Visit the Florida Victorious tent to learn more about the team and membership benefits, and also meet Gator student athletes. Join us for the chance to win a brand new Chevy Silverado on the field. Brought to you by Southern Chevy Dealers and Florida Victorious. Learn more about Florida Victorious and become a member at FloridaVictorious.com. FloridaVictorious.com. And help us make Florida victorious.
You know, people ask me all the time, Mia, why buy from Arlington Toyota? And when they do, here's what I tell them. Let's start with peace of mind. When you buy any new Toyota from Arlington, their lifetime warranty goes with you. That's unlimited time and miles. Plus, you get 30 days to love your pre-owned purchase or exchange it for one that you do. And you even get a complimentary car wash with your service visit. Now you know why you should buy from Arlington. 10939 Atlantic Boulevard and online at arlingtontoyota.com.
Hey folks, Mike Dempsey here. You've heard me talking about Pella windows and doors, and with great ratings and expert reviews, you know they're high quality and energy efficient products. So what's your next step? How about scheduling a free consultation or just stop by the Pella showroom right there on Phillips Highway next to Tesla? Pella's professional consultants will guide you through your entire project from start to finish. From simple projects to complex renovations, their team has the experience needed to make your project a success. And that's the quality and service you can expect from Pella Windows and Doors.
We're in Florida and pest problems are persistent. Want them gone? Mission accomplished with Mission Pest Solutions. Veteran and locally owned and operated, Mission Pest will blow your mind with their communication and response time for all your pest, termite, and mosquito needs. Text or call 904-944-PEST. You'll speak directly with the owners. Mention 1010XL when you call 944-PEST. You'll get 25% off your initial pest or termite protection service. Mission accomplished with Mission Pest Solutions.
The Jacksonville Icemen are playoff bound.
There are three regular season home games left.
Friday, Saturday, and Sunday at ViStar Veterans Memorial Arena. The Icemen fight for a division title this weekend, starting Friday against the Savannah Ghost Pirates.
The first 1,000 fans get a Fang the Mascot bobblehead.
Then Saturday at 7 and Sunday at 3, it's the Atlanta Gladiators. Get tickets at Ticketmaster, JacksonvilleIcemen.com, or call 904-602-PUCK. Icemen Hockey is hashtag Fire Within.
Follow golf's best players and compete against 1010XL and the rest of Duval in fantasy golf.
Look at this.
Win $1,000 of jewelry from Beard's Diamonds. Brought to you by Pella Windows and Doors. And MyBookie. Enter now at 1010XL.com.
It's Kubota Orange Days, your golden chance to score a deal that will make your neighbors green with envy. Shop the year's best selection of Kubota tractors, zero-turn mowers, and utility vehicles, including the number one selling compact tractor in the USA. And get the year's best deals, like 0% APR for 84 months or up to $3,300 off L3302 tractors. Coastal Equipment on New Kings Road and in McClenny.
Coastal Equipment.
Mueller Air Conditioning presents...
Are You Cool?
Today's challenger, a corporate management manager from Jacksonville, Florida. Meet Les Blankston.
Yeah, hi, Bob.
That is a remarkably beige suit there, Les. Tell us, why are you on the show?
Well, I just replaced my old air conditioner with a new one from Mueller, and I'm just so comfortable these days. I wondered, am I... cool now?
Let's find out, Les. Go ahead and spin the wheel.
That's right, Les. By upgrading your old AC to a more energy-efficient model from Bueller Air Conditioning, you'll save money, save energy, and proudly show your family that
you are cool!
Do you think I should get a mohawk?
Pace yourself, Les.
Stay cooler with Bueller.
Visit BuellerAir.com.
Mark Watson for Hardball Creative. Free promo tip. Put your logo on golf balls and give them to clients who are bad golfers. More hacks equals more exposure. Trust me, it's science. HardballCreative.com.
Hardball Creative. Hardball does it all.
Homeowners and investors, the choice of title company is yours. When making that decision, choose the team of St. John's Title, LLC. As board-certified expert attorney-owned firm with decades of experience, we provide the utmost in precision and professionalism. Conveniently located offices and in-home remote closing options, we serve your needs. Whether refinancing or selling your property, our customer-first approach is tailor-made to your timeline. With a seasoned team of experts and five-star testimonials from customers across the First Coast, call or visit St. John's Title today.
I-9 Sports wants to make sure kids all over the First Coast can enjoy growing up on a field or in a gym. And right now, summer and fall registration is open. So make sure you find out what I-9 Sports offers in your area across Duval, Clay, and St. John's. I9Sports.com. Enter 1010 in the promo code.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555. Jacksonville.
Nobody knows the Jags like Johnny O.
Oh, knows. Brought to you by
Kingfish Pest Control, proud partner of the Jacksonville Jaguars.
On 1010XL.
All right, somebody asked, they're curious to know what every team's single season sack record is. You know, compared to now the Jags is Josh Allen 17.5. I found a story from 2021 or 2022, but it's weird. It's not. Doesn't have all the information. Like, you start scrolling through by team, and, for instance, like the Falcons, John Abraham had, I think, 16.5, was it? And the Delvis Dumerville had 17 for the Ravens.
17 is probably the sweet spot.
It's right around there, yeah. Right? There are not too many guys up around 20. But what happened was, like, it started showing, like, so-and-so had the record for this team, and so-and-so match it, and didn't tell you what the number was. Like, well, I don't need to know who the record holder is. I'd like to know who the sack leaders are, but whatever, what the number is. But here we go. Let's just look at this. How many people have had more than 17.5 sacks in a season? Mm-hmm. What do you think that number is?
How many people?
How many total seasons of 18 sacks or better have there been?
I'd say 22, 23.
22, 23. Tone, what do you got?
I was going to go 15.
35.
Yeah. Okay.
There have been 35, 18 sack seasons.
The high teens has happened more than people think.
Reggie White, 18. I'm just looking at it. So you got four guys tied at 18. Then you got another big group at 18.5. Bosa, Nick Bosa, Dexter Manley going back. Von Miller, Robert Quinn. Just did that like 2 years ago, mm-hmm. two, 3 years ago. Strahan, Jason Taylor, Andre Tippett. We're talking about a lot of those guys, the legacy pass rushers,
yeah.
Right? Some of the greatest of all time. 19 sacks, Mark Gastineau, Chandler Jones, again with Robert Quinn, Clyde Simmons, Bruce Smith, T.J. Watt. Ain't no chumps in this list. I mean, you might get one who slips through the cracks, but Shaq Barrett, is he a 19.5 sack guy? Well, he did it.
He did it.
You know, in 2019, Tim Harris did it for Green Bay in 1989.
And for a couple of years, he was really, really good.
Alden Smith, bulky guy. DeMarcus Ware, Robert Mathis. And then, the top guys. You're talking Aaron Donald, Chris Dolman, Reggie White, Justin Houston, Jared Allen. They're all, like, almost all of them going to be in the Hall of Fame mm-hmm. one day.
Yeah, Houston, maybe not. But in their
– outstanding. Justin Houston's an outstanding pass rusher.
At their peak.
Right.
As good as they were.
Can we get a few more? That's the thing. Can we look, I don't expect 17.5 every year, but I would like to see 15 sack seasons become a regularity for Josh Allen over the next several years. I mean, $30 million ain't chump change, right? We're not paying you to be because you're a nice guy. Continue to produce at that level. You earned it. Let's continue to earn it. Let's get a couple calls in here with their reaction to Josh Allen and the Jags getting a 5-year deal worked out. Mike in McClenny is up next. Mike, you're on Jaguars Today. Go ahead, please.
Yeah, that's one thing about Josh. He stood around and he waited. He didn't complain about nothing. He just waited till his money came, and he got his money. Good job, Josh. Y'all want to see another Josh Allen coming up? Check out number 15 in Baker County at the Wildcats, Steph Chestnut.
Pockets, you got a scouting report for me? out of Baker County.
What was his name? Number 15. What was his name?
Number 15. I don't know.
Chase Sack.
I don't
Chestnut.
Know.
I think it was Seth Chestnut. Yeah, he's committed to Florida Atlantic. That's all I can tell you. He's pretty good.
All right.
If that's him.
All right. We'll keep our eye on him, Mike. Appreciate it. Pockets is our conduit to the prep scene. To Antony as well. But, John, I'm going to say you're not.
Not anymore. I used to be.
You used to be.
Back in the day.
I never was. Really. Although I did do a high school scoreboard show for a couple of years on another station.
I covered high schools for the TU from 88 to 93.
I did it right before the sweet spot of like the local TV stations having good web pages where you could actually like go and see what the scores were. And I remember the first year I did, there were nights when I'd have like scores of two games and I'd have like one person's stats.
Yeah.
Combined out of the two games, be like Leon Washington did it again for 280 yards, and I don't know what else happened.
Yeah, that was back in the days before cell phone and texting.
Friday Night Lights, like part of the novelty of having the winning coaches on was how'd the game go?
Yes, right? We want to know.
like what happened? We have no idea.
We don't know.
That's all out there. Like any of the information you want is available to you on X.
It is, but still, you know, if you're out there and you're a family that is participating in high school football on Friday night, cheerleading or playing football, whatever, and you're driving back from the game and you want to know how your division rival did, awesome. Let's get DJ checking in all the way from California this morning on Jaguars Today. Good morning, DJ.
Good morning, fellas. Hey, Mike, as always, it's very pleasant to talk to you guys this morning. It's extra pleasant now that Johnny O's there. I'd like to thank you guys for being there every morning, Monday through Friday, for me to have something to listen to when I'm, you know, creaking around. I'd like to thank Johnny O for giving me something to read 7 days a week.
Okay.
And I'd like to thank my local San Francisco 49ers for releasing Eric Armstead.
Hell yeah.
And dare I say, welcome back to Saxonville, boys.
Oh, it could be. I hope so, DJ. I hope so. We may need one more guy to help push them into that kind of stratosphere.
Devon Hamilton, bud. Devon Hamilton's coming back. He had that back
maybe
thing
so
last year. Like,
maybe so. Maybe
he's
so.
He's back to 2022 form.
Look, I'm not opposed to it, DJ. I'm just saying I got to see it. I hope you're right. I'm not ready to proclaim him Saxonville 2.0, but appreciate it. And by the way, might be the first person who's ever described listening and or talking to me as pleasant. Pretty sure. I mean, I don't think that's even much of a question.
Since I've been doing the show.
Right. Pleasant? Like, all right. I'll take it. I think it was meant in a good way. Yeah. DJ's just happy today. And
there goes that pleasant Mike Dempsey.
Yeah, yeah, right? Well, I thought he was going to thank the Niners for letting Balky free as well. So, you know, the architect, the masterclass architect, John, is what he is right now. Hey, look, in the end, man. Even the most ardent, balky detractors, I think almost all of them want to win games, want to win playoff games, want to get to a Super Bowl, and eventually win a championship. Even if it's Trent Baalke that has to get some of the credit, they'll swallow hard and move on.
I would hope so.
They'll be too drunk to worry about it next day.
If you don't want that, then I don't know that I never want to say somebody's not a fan, but I'm not sure what you're in it for if you're
– No, I do think there are people – because I know, because I am a spiteful person, John. You might find that hard to believe.
A pleasant, spiteful person.
Like when Reggie Jackson left the Yankees, right? In 1982, he came back. First time he came back. It's the only time in my life I've rooted against the Yankees. I was so mad that they didn't re-sign him that I rooted for him and the Angels in their first game in Yankee Stadium. And he hit a home run and they won. And – I was like, okay, it's out of my – you know what I mean? Like, I do think that there are some people that would rather be right than happy in the end. I think it's a small percentage.
That.
I think most of Jaguar fandom today is very happy. And even a lot of people saying, hey, man, I got to – even grudgingly, I'll give him some – Balky some credit. And, yes, you can acknowledge that it possibly could have had a different outcome if they got it done earlier. We don't know how likely it is that they could have gotten that done.
Yeah, I saw people specifically reacting on YouTube, asking questions along the lines of, how's Tony reacting today since I said I didn't think the deal was going to get done this year? It's like, I'm having a party.
He's happy.
How do you think I'm reacting today? I'm thrilled that they got this deal
done. Just
because
you think something doesn't mean you don't want something to happen.
Right, but that's it. Like, people root for your outcomes sometimes. Like, you, I predict this is going to happen, so now I'm going to root for that to happen. Well, maybe I predicted something, and there's a better outcome that happens, and it makes me wrong.
Yeah,
but it makes me happy.
Corner at 17. I don't care if they don't.
Yeah,
right. Like, In fact, I almost don't want them to. And it makes sense from a football standpoint. Like, I totally justifiable if they get a Terrion Arnold or whomever. I don't want Nate Wiggins, but that's enough. And again, I'm not a scout, so maybe the 173-pounder is exactly what the NFL has been waiting for, right, at that position. Who do we have? Was it Tony Pauline who told us that a lot of what – he's really fast, but he gets beat a lot, and the speed is on display because he's catching up to the receiver that got by him?
That sounds like something Tony would
– Tony would point out. All right, John, what do you got cooking over at Jaguars.com in the ensuing days here?
Hoping at some point to be writing about Josh Allen. Bucky Brooks on the Huddle Up podcast, we'll be having that later on today. We'll be talking about Josh Allen, the impact. And whenever Bucky's on, we get deep into the draft because he's the guy.
Why don't we squeeze in one more here? Just last word. Let's see if it's a positive one as we're on our way out the door. We got Jason in Julington Creek. We appreciate everybody's feedback this morning at 641-1010. Jason, go ahead.
Good afternoon. Love the show, guys.
Thank you.
I'm happy with the timeline and the time frame. I'm not really caring about Ridley. I think the offense was much more different without Jones versus Ridley. Love the show. Love the signing. Jags, baby. Let's go.
Jags, baby. I like it, Jason. Thank you for
paying off my
faith and taking one more caller.
Zay ought to be healthy going into the season next year, so let's see what that looks like.
Hey, healthy Zay, maybe Brian Thomas or maybe some receiver that we get in the third round could come in and make an impact. It happens.
It does.
It happens. Now, I get it. Your skepticism, well, it doesn't happen for Balky. Well, it doesn't happen for every GM.
It doesn't happen for
but
most
it does happen.
GMs. Yeah.
It does happen. Yeah. So can we root for the good outcome and
No.
Or you know what? Or how about this? Expect the worst, but maybe be pleasantly surprised if the best happens. If
pleasant
a good thing happens.
Is the buzzword of the day.
Pleasant.
Pleasant. Have a pleasant day.
Pleasant damn day. I hope, Tony, I hope you have a pleasant day tomorrow.
We'll see you on Monday.
Pleasant
man.
Day Friday.
Hit them straight.
Saturday and Sunday. Or have a terrible 4 days. It really
don't care.
Honestly,
right?
Doesn't matter to me. You know, because I'm still signing back here on Monday.
Right.
You know, as long as they put that contract out there, I will be back on Monday. We got a tough 4-day negotiating window to get through here and see. I've got to take less than you possibly believe, but I'm going to do it. I'm going to definitely less than 88 mil. All right, that'll do it for us today. Tony, you got John Shipley in studio tomorrow.
Yes, we will.
Right, from Jaguar Report. You got McManus, of course, on Friday. And for those who wanted to get in and talk about the draft today, I'm sure that will be available for you.
Plenty
in the next
of days.
Few, plenty of yes. days. Well, we're running out, but still enough. We got 2 weeks to go. Thanks to Demetrius Harvey for joining us today. Of course, John Osier for joining us today. For Tony Smith and Dylan Denmark, I'm Mike Dempsey. I'm off. Jaguars Today rolls on tomorrow with Tony and Big Ship coming in along with Dylan. So definitely tune in for the next couple of days and discuss all the great things and try to figure out exactly what the plan is heading into the draft, which will be 2 weeks from tomorrow. I'll see you Monday. Tone, have a great few days.
You too.
And way to go, Jags. No matter how you feel,
it's
I think
done.
We're all happy that Josh Allen is here for an extended period of time. Even if it's not the exact way you would have liked to have seen it go down, that aspect of it I think we can agree on. Have a great weekend, everybody, when you eventually get there, and I'll talk to you in a few days. Thanks for listening to Jaguars Today. Helmets and Heels coming up next on 1010XL and 92.5 FM.